What's up, Lacrosse.com faithful? Brendan St. Brown here. We are checking in at the World Lacrosse Super Sixes event. This is a new style of lacrosse, so let's break it down.
All right, this is what you need to know about the Super Sixes. It's 6-on-6 lacrosse, a 30-second shot clock. There are 4 8-minute quarters. Goalies initiate play after goals are scored. Draws and face-off occur only at the start of each quarter. It's a smaller field. The best way to describe this is it's a combination between field lacrosse, box lacrosse, and basketball.
We're here with Trey Deer. You've seen this guy's highlights before. Now Trey is in high school playing against pros. What's going through your head right now?
It's crazy. I'm just excited to be here. Can't wait to play with all the guys that I grew up watching, you know, idolizing all these guys, and now I get to share the field with them.
So you're playing with some of your idols. What's that like?
Oh, it's awesome. Like, growing up watching these guys play throughout college, like, I watched all their film, and now I'm sharing the field with them and, you know, hanging out with the boys and getting to know them even better, so it's just awesome. It's a dream come true.
Trey's just a student of the game, and he's about to make plays, so watch out for him.
Yes, sir.
All right, man. Thanks. We're here with Dana Dobie, who just killed it in the first game. Now, you got some battle scars on you.
I got some battle scars.
You got a cut on your nose, and you got a busted lip.
Yeah.
What happened?
Oh, it's so good. It's just like so fast up and back. And to be honest, I don't even remember when these happened in the game because we're just having so much fun playing. So, you know, it's lacrosse. You're going to get bruised up. You're going to get hit. And you just got to take it like a champ.
You just got to keep rolling. Roll with the punches.
Exactly.
We're here for game two. It's starting to rain a little bit, but that's all right. We're watching the Haudenosaunee men's national team take on the Canadian national team. We have a good one in store for us. This game is so exciting to watch. They're going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. With the Super Sixes in a closer field and a tighter field, you see a lot of quick shots. We're catching up with Lyle Thompson. Lyle is an ambassador to the sport of lacrosse. And one of the great things about the Super Sixes event is it's a great way to bring the world to lacrosse. Now, how have you seen lacrosse grow since the first time you picked up a stick?
I mean, I think it's being played a lot of different ways. Sixes, box, field, and I think you're seeing it in new places. That's the biggest thing. You can go sort of in all corners of the US and Canada and see it really blossoming, not just in the Northeast. So I think that's the biggest thing, is you're starting to see it more and more. The different places I travel anyways.
Yeah. What you said, there's a lot of different ways to play it. Now, someone who's never played lacrosse before, if they pick up a stick for the first time, what I like to say is you see a bar and you see a basket. You got craftiness and you got toughness. And I think that's a great way where lacrosse comes together, is you need skill and you need to be tough.
Yeah, I mean, skill, creativity, athleticism, it's a combination of so many different games. You know, it's got, you know, the positioning of basketball, it's got the athleticism of football with the midfielders, it's got the physicality of hockey, and then the skill aspect is the uniqueness of the game. So I think it brings a whole lot to the table, and it's so fun.
Absolutely. The Haudenosaunee just made a huge play. No time left on the clock. Found the back of the net, and it looks like they just tied it up. Now we're going into overtime. Right now we're vlogging, and we have to try to get this last goal on the story. Loose ball on the crease. Jeff T does what Jeff T does best and ends the game in overtime. 17-16, Canada. We're here with Ryan Drenner. Ryan, this is a new style of play, man. What's been your favorite part so far of the Super Sixes?
Yeah, I think to begin, I think meeting a lot of the guys that I normally play against. So getting to know those guys and sharing the field out here has been awesome. But also just this style of play is a lot of fun. It's very similar to basketball, which I grew up playing. So I have a little bit of comfortability here out there, but you know, it's a new discipline, and you know, I think with that territory, it's a lot of fun to learn and then get out there and execute.
You brought up that you played basketball, so I'm sure the crossover is probably similar.
Yeah, so I think the biggest similarity is one, there's five guys or girls out there playing, but it's very up and down with the 30-second shot clock. You know, once you settle into your offense, you kind of got to look for a great shot right off the bat, and then you got to quickly get back and play some defense.
We can't wait to see what he does on the field.
Appreciate it.
We're here with Lois Garlo. Lois, your team has a very unique kind of bond about you guys. Can you tell us a little bit about your team?
Yeah, absolutely. So our team is full of creative players. We're not selfish at all. We like to feed. We like to make creative plays. We like to go behind the back, between the legs, everything. You know, we're all just kind of just a family, to be quite honest. And we want each other just to succeed. And I think that's one of the things that sets us apart from everybody else, just our creativeness.
Is there anything that you guys do off the field together that you think brings you guys closer on the field?
Absolutely. I mean, we hang out. I know we don't get many opportunities to hang out before these events because we all live across the world. So, you know, when we get to the hotels, we just hang out, talk to each other, play little games, little ninja here and there. And we just try to get together as much as possible, have little singing parties, just do whatever we can to get the connection off the field and then on the field because that'll correlate.
Perfect. It's pouring rain out here. We're in the middle of the storm, but the vlog must go on. Canada beat my Americans 17-14. They are 2-0 on the day. Post game recovery is crucial. We got Team Canada in the ice basket right now. How's the water right now?
It's not too bad. It's freezing.
Yeah, it's kind of cold. Well, all right, though. 2-0 on the day, though. Big win. Big win. So, how are we liking the Sixers so far?
Fun.
Love it.
What's the biggest difference that you find from Sixes to the field?
Very fast pace.
Fast pace.
No weight meter, no fan, no shooting space. I mean, it's box across. It's what we grew up playing.
Yeah.
Game number four here, Team USA versus Team Canada. Team Canada women's lags just defeated Team USA. We'll see if Team USA men's lags can avenge their loss. Lacrosse just found the net on his knees. Team USA comes out on top in the end, defeating Canada 18-17. Game number five, this is the last girls matchup today. We have Team USA versus the Haudenosaunee. Let's see what they got. Team USA had it rolling, 19-9. We've reached the last game. We have Team USA versus the Haudenosaunee. Both teams are well lit, so we'll see who comes out on top. Ryner Garnsey is making magic on the lacrosse field. Team USA comes out with a victory, 16-11. That's a wrap for this vlog. The Super Sixes is a high-intensity, high-speed style of play. I believe this style of play will grow huge in popularity. Help us grow the sport of lacrosse by liking this video and subscribing to our channel. I'm Brendan St. Brown with Lax.com.